I've been waiting for something like this for a very, very long time.
It was about time this kind of energy came to Australia.
I came here feeling very stressed from the day, week of work, and I leave feeling so much lighter and happy and joyful.
I had a really beautiful evening tonight. It was super powerful just to feel the energy of all the voices singing together.
And I love dancing and singing along.
It was so beautiful. It was so nourishing for the soul.
We really need to do this once in a while.
I had a really great time playing music with Avishai and Amir, and we didn't really know what to expect for the first time, but we had a room of singers.
Let's all meet tonight with our voices and build together for the here and now a temple of song.
Welcome back to the Shtick. You've just seen a bit of Temple of Song, which was on last year at Beth Wiseman. And one of the people who coordinated that evening was Ariella Gerry.
Hi.
Hi, Ariella. Nice to have you on the Shtick.
Thank you. Good to be here.
We're here to tell people about this event that goes on every so often. It's an occasional thing. It's not regular.
Mm-hmm.
And I've been to one or two of them, and I love the feeling. There's another one coming up in Melbourne on the 16th of February.
That's right.
Yep. Yeah. What's this Temple of Song all about?
Okay, so Temple of Song is a place where people come together to sing Hebrew songs, mainly old traditional Hebrew songs and niggunim. It is run by three extraordinary musicians, Avishai, Barnatan, Amir Paiss, and Shai, Shriki. And they come down, they all live in Mullumbimby, and they fly all the way down here every few months to lead us in song. They are incredible musicians, and that it could be a gig, we could just sit and watch, but the idea is not to watch. The idea is that the kind of audience becomes the participants, and they're there to guide us to sing these Hebrew songs. Avishai and Amir are from the band Sheva, they're all Israeli, and it's all about singing these beautiful songs together.
I think that the whole atmosphere is so important to get people into a space where they feel there's a community. And it's something really special. I feel it's a unique kind of thing where people can find a level of joy and you know, through singing and dancing, because people do get up and dance, mm-hmm. which I really love that part of it where people, we saw a little bit of the at the beginning of the show, and we're also going out at the end with this kind of thing that you can't really describe. It's really hard to put into words. There's something about the atmosphere in these events that I've been to and I've seen, because you actually have a Facebook page, Temple of Song, and a website, templeofsong.com.au, which is coming up on the screen. So if anybody's interested in seeing what this is all about and come along to Temple Beth, what date is it?
16th of February, and yeah, the venue has changed. So it is at Temple Beth Israel this time.
which is a beautiful place. They've just dedicated it as a concert space recently when they had David Broza on, where both the fellows, Avishai and Amir, turned up and played with him on the second concert.
Yes.
And that really brought the atmosphere up, didn't it?
Yeah.
You get all these Israelis on stage together.
Yeah.
And that's what it's like. That's what it's all about, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, we really try to create a special space where it is beyond coming to kind of have a good time, although it is incredibly joyous, but it is about something quite deep. Mm. You know, I think that the aim is to really connect to Jewish tradition and culture.
Yeah.
So the songs that we choose are ones that are, you know, the old niggunim, old traditional Hebrew songs. And so there is a kind of experience of the tradition, which I think that, you know, that's what makes it unique, is that it's an experiential thing. So we're not coming and we're not kind of learning or being told something, which often my experience of Judaism is that, especially the secular Judaism is quite intellectual. And we're trying to go beyond that and say, well, can we actually feel this? Can we experience this? Can we connect to something that's bigger than us and beyond us through participation?
And the thing that I love most about it is the spontaneity, where people can't help themselves but sing along. Even if you don't know the songs, you still feel the tune, and it imbues you with a spiritual kind of thing that only Judaism has, I think.
Absolutely. And the way that we sit in the concentric circles, we're all looking at each other, and it kind of creates a surround sound. It really gives you this feeling of being amongst others and the power of community and doing something with these other people, connection. I mean, what better thing to do than to sing in a group of people? It's a powerful experience.
It certainly is. Yeah. Ariel, it's really great that you came along on the Shtick and told us all about it. And if anybody wants to come along on the 16th of February, you're very welcome to come and participate. And we'll see you next week with more Shtick, because every week we're here until whenever we finish.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much. And to all our viewers, shalom.
Sing together the Shalom, Shalom. Just turn around and look at your neighbor and just greet each other and bless each other with shalom, with peace. May we all carry that spark of peace within us wherever we go. May we take even one drop of love from here and bring it to the rivers of our life wherever we go.